सदाशिवसमारंभां शंकराचार्य मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम्। श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानाम् आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बातरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने नमो वीरवरमूर्ते नमः। सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यंकरवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। यो ब्रह्माण विधाति गुरु वेदाश्च प्रहिणोति तस्मै तगुं भविता शरणं प्रपद्ये। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। आमना यांतिक संसिद्धमादि मध्यांतवर्जितम् आनंदघनमापूर्णमात्मज्योतिरुपासमहे। श्रीधराय सो उपादानात्, वी सॉ द लास्ट सूत्र इज उपादानात्। प्राणानां विज्ञानेन विज्ञानम् आदाय इति आत्मनः ग्रहणशक्ति उपादान श्रवणात् अकर्तुः उपादान अयोगात् आत्मनः कर्तृत्वम् इत्यर्थः। आत्मा इज द कर्ता, बुद्धि इज नॉट द कर्त्री। वाय? बिकॉज द श्रुति ऑल्सो सेज एज टू आदाय हैविंग टेकन वॉट विज्ञानम विज्ञानेन प्राणानां, प्राणस आर इंद्रियास देर। सो इंद्रियाणां विज्ञानेन, विज्ञान अर्लियर विज्ञान वर्ड मीन शक्ति, द सेकंड विज्ञान वर्ड विज्ञानम मीन शक्ति हियर, एंड विज्ञानेन थ्रू द विज्ञान थ्रू द बुद्धि हैविंग टेकन द शक्ति ऑफ इंद्रियास, दैट वाज द अर्थ। आई एम रिविजिटिंग इट बिकॉज इन द एंड आई फेल्ट दैट आई रश थ्रू दिस। And thereby, Atma is the one who is connected as Karta with Adaya, Levanta Pada. Having taken the Shakti of the Pranas, Indriyas, through Vijnana Buddhi. That is the meaning there. So, such being the case, Karta is clearly whoever is the Vyakrana Karta in the Adaya Pada. That is Atma. So, Atma having taken the Shakti of the Indriyas, that is meaning through Buddhi, therefore Buddhi is Karana. Buddhi is not the Kartri, Buddhi is Karana. And who is the Karta then? Atma is the Karta, Jivatma is the Karta. Who is, of course, having identification with the Shariratraya, Tadatmya Sambandhina, but still the Karta is Jivatma, therefore he is the one we saw earlier who will get the Karma Phala. अपि च इन कंटिन्यूएशन इन द कर्तृधिकरणम् व्यपदेशाच्च क्रियायां न चेन् निर्देश विपर्ययः। व्यपदेशाच्च क्रियायां न चेन् निर्देश विपर्ययः। सो निर्देश विपर्ययः इज द रिजल्टेंट इफ यू डू नॉट एग्री। व्हाट इज द पदच्छेद? व्यपदेशात् च क्रियायां न चेत् निर्देश विपर्ययः। सो विपर्य निर्देश विपर्य इज द रिजल्ट एज टू द टीचिंग शुड बी इन अनदर मैनर, वुड हैव बीन अनदर मैनर। निर्देश विच इज बीन गिवन द टीचिंग विद द शब्द वेर, सो द एग्जाम्पल नॉट द एग्जाम्पल द विषय, द विषय विषय मंत्र हियर इज विज्ञानम यज्ञं तनुते। सो दैट इज द मंत्र देर, तैत्तिरीय उपनिषद मंत्र। After that, there is another, because we need that in the vritti. Vijnanam yajnyan tanute karmani tanute picha. So the Chaitri Upanishad Shruti says, Vijnanam yajnyan tanute, and tanute is kartari prayoga there. So yajnya is the karma there. Who does the yajnya? Vijnanam. Now this can be the Purva Paksha also. Vijnana Shabda is what? Earlier you have said that it is Vijnanena, there you said Buddhi. Pranana Vijnanena. So there Vijnana has been used twice, and both have different meanings. Here the shabda vijnanena, there the pratipadika vijnana means buddhi, and the second word vijnanam means shakti. Whereas vijnanam, in vijnanam yajnyantanute, there vijnana is a kartru karaka pada, kartru vachaka pada, and that karta is jiva, kartru karaka, and is also karta. So vyakrana karta in the vijnanam yajnyantanute is also the karma karta, yajna karta, and this is the vaidika. Laukika karma is also included. Vaidika karma, yajna is vaidika karma, and then karmani tanute picha. So that also shows laukika karma. It has not been quoted in the vritti, but that is the following mantra in the Chaitri Upanishad. So vyapadeshat, this is the teaching, vyapadeshat, due to such teaching, and due to such teaching of what? So what is the basic sutrartha we can make? Kriyayam vijnanam yajnam tanute, in that mantra iti sarva kriyayam, vaidika laukika kriyayam sarva kriyayam vijnana shabda, vijnana shabda vachyasya, what is the vachya, vachaka is vijnana pada, what is the vachya of that, meaning pada is vijnana, what is the padartha for vijnana, it is not buddhi, it is jivatma. So vijnana shabda vachyasya atmanah jivatmanah kartrutva vyapadeshacha. So vyapadesha, because such teaching exists, and since the adhikarana is kartru, kartra adhikarana, sutra has kartru adhyahara, or you can say anuvritti itself, wherever kartru pada has been used in this adhikarana. So kartru vyapadeshacha, that is the meaning of vyapadeshat, because of the teaching of karta for the kriyas, in the kriyas, kriyayam. In the kriyas, this is saptami ekvachana, kriyayam. So in the kriya, who is the karta? In the yajna kriya here, yajnyan tanute, or karmani tanupe tanute picha. There, who is the karta? Karta is vijnana, and that vijnana is vachaka of the vachya, which is atma. Purva Bhakshi says, no, earlier you have said that vijnana can stand for buddhi, it can stand for shakti also. Then why is it that here vijnana has to stand for atma? Why not vijnana be vachaka and vachya be buddhi? Na chet, if at all you do not agree, says the Siddhanti to the Purva Bhakshi, nirdesha viparyayaha. There should be viparyayaha, difference in nirdesha, in pointing out. Through the karaka. So nirdesha, karaka nirdesha, viparyaya syat. Should have been, the Shruti should have said, what? Vijnanena there. Had vijnana shabda been buddhi vachaka, not atma vachaka, then vijnanam should not have been the prathama vibhakti. There shouldn't have been vijnanam in neuter as prathama vibhakti. Which vibhakti should have the shruti use then? Or would the shruti have been, Shruti would have used vijnanena, tritiya. Why so? Because that is how it has been used in all shrutis. Example is pranaanam vijnanena vijnanam adaya. There itself you have an example. And since the kartruvachaka pada prathama has been used, therefore it cannot stand for the karana buddhi. Further argument will be made in the vritti that comes up across sutras. बट दिस इज द बेसिक आइडिया ऑफ द सूत्र विज्ञान यज्ञ तनुते इत्यादि लौकिक वैदिक क्रियायां विज्ञान शब्द वाच्यस्य आत्मना कर्तृत्व उपदेशात् यदि विज्ञान शब्दो बुद्धिपरः जीवपरः न चेत् तर्हि निर्देश विपर्ययः स्यात्। नथिंग डिफरेंट फ्रॉम व्हाट वी सॉ इन द वृत्ति, सो देयर इज रिपीटेशन इन द पाठ। इन द मंत्र विज्ञान यज्ञ तनुते विज्ञान डज यज्ञ इत्यादो इत्यादो मीन्स दि फॉलोइंग मंत्र कैन ऑल्सो बी इंक्लूडेड एज कर्माणि तनुते पिच। सो देयर यज्ञ इज वैदिक कर्म एंड कर्माणि इन द नेक्स्ट वाक्य नेक्स्ट मंत्र ऑफ द चैत्रीय उपनिषद इज लौकिक कर्म। यू कैन टेक इट एज लौकिक कर्म। देयर वाय लौकिक वैदिक क्रियायां इन दोज लौकिक एंड वैदिक क्रियाज हू इज द कर्ता विज्ञान शब्द वाच्य इज द कर्ता। सो विज्ञान शब्द वाच्यस्य आत्मनः जीवात्मनः कर्तृत्व उपदेशात् श्रुति हैज क्लियरली शोन आत्मा एज द कर्ता देयर। पूर्व पक्षी से देयर इज नथिंग कॉल्ड एज क्लियरली शोन, दैट क्लियरली एडवर्ब इज नॉट नीडेड हियर। व्हाई? बिकॉज विज्ञान कैन स्टैंड फॉर बुद्धि ऑल्सो बाय करणे व्युत्पत्ति, हैज टू से करणे व्युत्पत्ति। यदि विज्ञान शब्द बुद्धिपरः न जीवपरः चेत, सो इफ दी विज्ञान शब्द इज इन द मीनिंग ऑफ बुद्धि एंड नॉट इन द मीनिंग ऑफ जीव जीवात्मा, देन व्हाट विल हैपन? तर्हि निर्देश विपर्ययः स्यात्। देयर वुड बी और शुड बी निर्देश विपर्ययः, देयर शुड बी चेंज इन निर्देश द वे द वाक्य कंस्ट्रक्ट हैज बीन शोन। निर्देश इज पॉइंटिंग आउट समथिंग, सो श्रुति शुड हैव यूज द कारका विच इज अप्रोप्रिएट टू पॉइंट आउट बुद्धि, नॉट दैट विच इज अप्रोप्रिएट फॉर जीव। दिस इज द आर्ग्यूमेंट मेड बाय द सिद्धांति। व्हाट इज द एक्सप्लेनेशन फर्दर? बुद्धे कर्णत्वेन विज्ञानम इति कर्तृत्व निर्देशस्य विज्ञानेन इति कर्णत्व विपर्ययः स्याद् इत्यर्थः। बिकॉज बुद्धि इज करण, बुद्धि इज नॉट कर्त्री, इफ द श्रुति हैज टू शो बुद्धि एज नॉट बुद्धि विज्ञान एज पॉइंटिंग टू बुद्धि, देन सिंस बुद्धि इज कर्ण इट हैज टू हैव यूज्ड विज्ञान प्रातिपदिका डिक्लाइंड इन तृतीया एज कर्ण। सो शुड हैव बीन विज्ञानेन यज्ञं तनुते। इनफैक्ट हैड दी श्रुति यूज विज्ञानेन, देयर ऑल्सो यू वुड हैव सेड विज्ञानेन इज कर्ण, देयर फोर कर्ता इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम कर्ण, एंड दैट आर्ग्यूमेंट इज गोइंग टू कम अप लेटर। बट हियर द बेसिक आर्ग्यूमेंट इज सिंस प्रथम हैज बीन यूज, देन यू कैन क्लेम व्याकरण कर्ता, बट दी बुद्धि इज कर्ण, देयर फोर इट शुड बीन तृतीया इन व्याकरण। This is the argument given by the Siddhanti, Buddhehe Karanatvena Hetuna Vijnanam iti Kartrutva Nirdeshasya. The Nirdesha pointing out which has already been done by the Shruti as Vijnanam in the first case, Tasya Kartrutva Nirdeshasya Vijnanena iti Karanatva, Karanatva Viparyaha Tritiya Vibhakti Viparyaha Syad, should have been. Should have been vijnanena in third case, not in first case as vijnanam in napunsakalinga with lyut pratyaya. This lyut pratyaya, all right, it can be in as a vyutpatti, you can make akartari chakarakayam sanyayam, akartari chakarake sanyayam. So lyut falls into that adhikara in vyakrana, and therefore you can have different vyutpattis. But since buddhi is karana, then karaka you should have been tritiya, says the siddhanti there. Nanu svatantrasya atmanah kartrutve anishtam na kuryat ishtamiva kuryat ityata ah. Now the purvapakshi takes a different approach to this argument that is presenting to establish buddhi as a kartri. He has failed. So to establish buddhi as a kartri, he tries a different methodology as to showing the flaw in Jiva being the karta. If Jiva is a karta, he says, why would any Jiva choose to do something which is anishta, undesirable? Generally, you can say, now who likes this? Nobody will like that. Such categories do exist. Although there are particular differences between taste, there is some general case. As we see the definition in Tarka Shastra also for Sukha and Dukha is with the general case. Sukha is something that everyone desires. Dukha is something that nobody desires or everyone wants to avoid. So such general cases do exist. In that case, with that, in that case means in the case Jiva is karta, and taking the general case of what is desirable to the populace and what is not for each and every individual, why would anyone choose to be doing something which is undesirable? Everyone has to choose what is desirable. But we do see that people end up doing something which is undesirable many a time, not once or twice, not by mistake. They end up choosing something which is dukkha karaka, adharma. Adharma is going to result in dukkha. Maybe immediate, maybe in a long term, maybe across different janmas, but adharma, which may be giving a prior result in the immediately. A shortcut method to gain some immediate satisfaction or satiation of desires. But in the long term, it is not good. It will create dukkha. And this is Anubhava Siddha. Shastra may or may not teach some things. What Shastra has taught is fine. But if somebody who has not studied Shastra or does not follow the Shastra, for such Charvaka also, happiness is needed. And he knows by Anubhava that what I have done has not resulted in Sukha which has stayed for long. But still that entity knowingly does something which results in Dukkha in the long term, and he knows that. Why would anyone choose such kind of a thing with or without Shastra training? Why would anyone choose being an independent karta to do something which is undesirable, which brings undesirable results? While doing also there is dukkha, it will bring dukkha later also. Why would anyone do it? This is the argument of the Purvapakshi. Nanu Swatantrasya Atmana. This Jiva who is Swatantra Karta. Because Vyakarana Sutra also, Panini Maharshi says in Ashtadhyayi, who is the Karta? Swatantra Karta. Sutra itself says, Swatantra Karta. Karta is one who is Swatantra. That which is Swatantra. If it is neuter, in the Vakya analysis. Ekating Vakyam. Vakya with a verb has to have a Karta. May or may not have a karta which is explicitly mentioned. But you can inquire who is the karta. Whoever is swatantra is karta there. Whatever is the swatantra pada there is karta. That is the karta. So this atma being karta, atma will become swatantra. If atma is swatantra, then why will this jivatma who is swatantra choose to do anishta? So kartrutve sati. When you claim the Atma to be, Jivatma to be Swatantra, then Anishtam na Kuriyat. Saha Jivaha Anishtam na Kuriyat. Would not do Anishta. Undesirable. Ishtam eva Kuriyat. Would choose to do only Ishta, what is desirable. Ichyataha. To that objection, the Siddhanti Sutrakara replies, Upalabdhivad Aniyamaha. Upalabdhivad Aniyamaha. Upalabdhivat aniyamaha. Aniyamaha, there is no such rule. Like what? Upalabdhi. उपलब्धि, व्हाट इज द उपलब्धि, उपलब्धि इज भोगा हियर, एनी एक्सपीरियंस भोगा फॉर अ भोक्ता. हियर यू आर सेइंग कर्ता, कर्ता शुड नॉट डू समथिंग विच इज अनिष्टा, वुड नॉट डू समथिंग विच इज अनिष्टा, वुड डू ओनली इष्टा. देन वील से ओके शुद्ध भोक्ता, वॉट अबाउट स्वतंत्र भोक्ता? द शुद्ध भोक्ता, भोक्ता ऑल्सो शुड नॉट हैव एनी भोगा विच इज अनिष्टा, शुड हैव ओनली इष्ट भोगा. बट डू वी सी दैट युअर पुरुषा सांख्यास, ही इज टॉकिंग टू द सांख्यास और गिविंग सांख्यास एज एग्जाम्पल. लुक एट द सांख्यास पुरुषा हु इज भोक्ता नॉट अ कर्ता, बट डज ही हैव चॉइस इन वॉट काइंड ऑफ भोगा? Whatever comes by, you know, whether it is desirable or undesirable, ishta or anishta, purusha has to undergo bhoga. That is the entire journey of the purusha, trying to avoid this anishta samsara. He wants to be mukta. So for sankhya is also same case. How can the bhokta be having bhoga which is anishta? So just like in Sankhya's case, Bhokta does not have choice in what kind of bhoga he'll have to undergo. Similarly, this Karta also does not have choice in that sense, meaning although independent to choose, ends up doing something which is undesirable, meaning ends up choicelessly with his choice making a choice. Choicelessly making a choice as though. It may seem contradictory, but that is the situation. Anubhava Siddha. How many times we hear others say, if we may not express, but we hear others say, hey, I did not want to do that, but I ended up doing that. Did you have a choice? Yes, I had a choice. I actually didn't want to do it. But somehow, you know, I ended up. Then as an afterthought, I say that, okay, I shouldn't have done that, which is the case now. This fellow is talking and he says that, oh, I didn't want to do it. Somehow, you know, I was not thinking straight. This is what happens. The buddhi is overshadowed by the manaha, manas. The antakkarana, which plays the role of buddhi as well as manas, while playing the role of manas, which is under strong emotions, samskaras are driving those emotions, and then under the influence of those emotions, buddhi does not get to step in at all. There is no bandwidth available for buddhi to step in and choose right from wrong. Mana is just throwing options. Do this, do that. So between this or that, buddhi can help conclude. Nishchayatmika buddhi. Samshayatmakam manaha. That samshayatmakam manaha creates doubt as to whether this is appropriate or that is appropriate and tries to justify as to, look at this, you had some sukha there. So that sukha is the focus, immediate sukha. But the dukkha that follows is lost. Simple example is a diabetic knows that there is going to be a lot of trouble if one intakes sweet being a diabetic, but then the sweet is so ishta that one ends up taking that which will lead to dukkha later. This is the case of the bhokta, because eating sweet is still ishta, therefore it will not apply to the karta as he is doing something anishta. But for Bhokta's case, he ends up suffering. That is the flaw in the Sankhya system as to somebody is eating because it is Ishta. So the Karta is different from the Bhokta. Purusha is not the Karta at all. So what will happen? Karta at all in the sense? Prakriti is the Karta. Pradhana is the Karta. So if you look at Pradhana, with this example, you can show the flaw in the Sankhya system, which we have seen earlier also, and we have refuted that. But just as a reminder here, as to what is this Upalabdhi Vatu, just like Sankhya's, वेयर भोक्ता हैज नो चॉइस बट हैज टू सफर विथ वॉट एवर इज सर्व कर्म. वॉट इट मीन्स इज कर्म. वॉट एवर कर्म इज सर्व कर्म फला. कर्म मीनिंग कर्म फला. कर्म हैज बोथ मीनिंग्स ऑफ कर्म एज वेल एज कर्म फला मीनिंग क्रिया एंड फला. सो एंड्स अप हैविंग अनुभव ऑफ वॉट एवर हैज बीन सर्व बाय द थियरी ऑफ कर्म. बट इन द सांख्यास केस व्हाट इज द थियरी ऑफ कर्म. प्रधान इज द कर्त्री. प्रधानम इज द कर्तृ एंड द पुरुष इज द भोक्ता. बट इफ यू टेक अ कर्ता हु इज स्वतंत्र दैट कर्ता वुड नॉट डू समथिंग विच इज अनिष्ट. देयर वी कैन पिक अप एन एग्जाम्पल विच इज नॉट दिस डायबिटिक एग्जाम्पल. But it is something which is, you can take it for a person who knows adharma, the case of doing adharma. So adharma is anishta, which the dharmika knows. But somebody who has no training in dharma, as a general case, you'll have to take something which is undesirable while doing itself. Something which is painful to do. Why would someone do something which is painful, which will not bring a painless or a joyful result. So such kind of a case has to be picked up as to while doing also there is a lot of effort and later also there is a lot of pain. Why would anyone do it? So a lot of cases in the office, whatever our bosses tell us, we do end up doing. We don't want to do it. Something which is wrong also, we end up doing choicelessly. So that is the case. Or not forced by someone also, but choicelessly someone ends up doing something which while doing also he knows that it is not good at all for that person. So yadvad upalabdhau swatantraha api atma ishtam anishtam cha upalabhate. So this shuddha bhokta So what example can you take there? So so in Shastra the example is, I think it has said, there is an enemy. Yeah, that can work for karta as well as bhokta. So look at so this is a good example, interesting example rather, of jealousy. So So imagine Chaitra and Maitra are not friends, they are enemies. And Chaitra has built a palatial mansion. So he has kind of a palace, his house is like a palace. And Maitra has to pass by that road. Every day he is passing by that road on the way to work. He has to go from the same lane. And while going, the road is shaped in such a manner, it turns in such a manner that he cannot avoid looking at the looking at the Chaitra's mansion, which will cause jealousy and pain there. So this Maitra is going on the road and choicelessly he is forced to see Chaitra's palace, whereby this Maitra will experience pain. So as a bhokta, shuddha bhokta also of Sankhya's, it will work as he has no choice, does not choose to have this pain, but has to undergo that pain. As a karta, why does he see then? It is in the line of sight. Even if he looks on the road is up the hill, and up the hill, just behind that up the hill road is the rising mansion of Chaitra. So in the line of sight he cannot avoid, it is there line of sight and it is in the frame of vision, the Chaitra's palace will be there in the frame of vision. This fellow cannot avoid, Maitra cannot avoid. So as a karta also he cannot avoid, as a bhokta also he cannot avoid, and while looking at that there is a pain. As a karta you can take another example also. He does not want to show the jealousy. Let's say this Maitra is considering Chaitra as an enemy, or not an enemy, but he is jealous. Maybe they are friends, or you know, he wants to be a good person, and you know, Chaitra has done a lot of favors to Maitra, and asks him to help out with some something in the palace, which will make the palace even better. So Maitra has to help because Maitra says that, oh, so many favors have been done, it will not look good if I don't repay. But then he has a choice not to do it. Ends up helping Chaitra, where while doing it, this jealousy is troubling him so much that he experiences dukkha. And later also it is not going to bring him sukha. It is going to be pain all the way. Of course, because it is a neutral karya or a dharma, it may not result in dukkha by itself. But his samskaras and mind is shaped in such a manner that he is having dukkha while doing it, and later also there is dukkha. But ends up doing. Therefore, this example will work in all cases. Or as a bhokta also, headache. Headache is anishta, but why does the bhokta choose to have headache? Can he choose to have a headache? No, the shirovedana is a result of some karma, earlier karma, or scientifically due to something. He does not even know why he is getting headache, does not want to get headache, but gets headache. For that headache, immediately one can take medication. But that medication has a side effect also, where there is a stomach ache or whatever it is, you know. Knowingly, the person takes it as a karta, but has no choice. So, you know, because upalabdhivat aniyamaha, very difficult to express that. Although the vritti is very short, we need a long explanation to understand. Some of these sutras are complex with a short vritti. Some are simple with a short vritti, there we can just, you know, go through fast. But here it is tricky to understand, because many people will think, oh, I didn't choose, I can choose wiser. It is not so. Sometimes you are driven to take a choice which is unwanting. Do not want to make that choice, but you make a choice. So, yadvad upalabdho svatantra api atma, bhokta. Ishtam anishtam cha upalabhate, gets both ishta and anishta. It is not that only anishta, we are not saying only anishta. Ishta also, anishta also. There is no niyama as to only this ishta has to be picked by bhokta. Similarly, only ishta has to be picked by karta is not a niyama at all. Tadvata ishtam anishtam cha sampadayati. Sampadayati means karoti. Iti karta karoti. Yatha bhokta anishtam ishtam cha karoti. तथैव कर्ता अपि इष्टमनिष्टञ्च करोति एव इति अनियमः इत्यर्थः. देर इज नो सच रूल टू कैटेगराइज एंड से कैटेगरिकली से ओ हैज टू चूज इष्टा इफ इट इज इफ ही इज स्वतंत्र कर्ता. इतश्च आत्मने एव कर्तृत्वं न बुद्धेर इत्यतः. एंड ड्यू टू दिस रीजन ऑल्सो 38 सूत्र कर्तृत्व इज ऑफ द जीव नॉट ऑफ बुद्धि. मीनिंग बुद्धि इज नॉट द कर्त्री. जीवात्म इज कर्तव्य शक्ति विपर्ययात. शक्ति विपर्ययात अनदर डिफिकल्ट सूत्र हैज इन शक्ति विपर्यय. देर विल बी चेंज इन शक्ति. देर इज चेंज इन शक्ति. व्हाट इज द चेंज इन शक्ति देर. बुद्धेः कर्तृत्वे करणशक्ति विपर्ययात. नाउ दिस विपर्ययात, दिस हैज बीन शोन इन द मंत्र प्राणानां विज्ञानेन विज्ञानम् आदाय, विच वी हैव सीन अर्लियर एट द ओपनिंग ऑफ द पाठ. प्राणानां विज्ञानेन विज्ञानम् आदाय. देर दि शक्ति इज बीइंग टेकन. विच शक्ति हैज बीन टेकन. दिस प्राण इंद्रिय शक्ति हैज बीन टेकन बाय समवन. इफ द बुद्धि इज द कर्त्री, देन दैट शक्ति दैट इट हैज टेकन फ्रॉम द इंद्रियास, विच शक्ति विल इट हैव टेकन. In the case of Jiva, that the Siddhanta is saying Jiva is Karta, there Jiva is taking the Indriya Shakti. So there is a Shakti Parivartana in the Jiva. obviously if you take some shakti, then shakti change is taking place within. So that is simple artha there, as in shakti viparyaya. Shakti viparyaya is there or not in the karta. When karta does something, something changes. Similarly, karta is taking the shakti of the pranas, prana shabda meaning indriyas. So indriya shaktis are being taken by the karta. So whoever is the karta, having taken the indriya shaktis, there has to be change in the shakti. If jiva takes the shakti of indriyas, then jiva will have change in shakti. We don't have any issue there. But in your case, the Purvapakshi's case, if buddhi is taking the shakti of the other, then that shakti change which has to be undergone by buddhi, what will that result in? What is our understanding there? We have to inquire into that, says the Sutrakara. So buddhe kartrutve sati, if buddhi is the kartri, then karana shakti viparyayat. Karana shakti, which is already there in the buddhi. Why? Buddhi is karana. Buddhi is karana, that we have established, and it has been seen all over in the Shruti Smriti Granthas. It is also anubhava siddha to the person that I am using buddhi. Now this buddhi by itself, you can take Vijnanamaya Kosha also. Vijnanamaya Kosha itself is the kartri. Purvapakshi is claiming buddhi, the intellect. The intellect is the kartri. Then what will happen? That karana shakti will change because it has gained some other power. What power? To be a karta now. Having taken the indriya shakti, what? Does something. Jiva does something, taking the shakti from the indriyas. I see, I am doing, I am going by taking the shakti from the karmendriyas. Hastendriya, Padendriya, what does one do? One grasps something, one walks. So Jiva starts walking. By what? He has no shakti to walk. He takes the shakti from the Padendriya and walks. Becomes the karta of walking. To grasp something, to hold something, he grasps the indriya, Hastendriya shakti, and starts grasping things. Similarly to see, Jiva is seeing. What does it mean? He takes the shakti from the indriyas and starts seeing. Of course, this Jiva is not independent Atma. Meaning, the Shuddha Atma is not the case here. Jiva Atma is one who has Tadatma Sambandha. Having Tadatma Sambandha with indriyas, he claims the indriya shakti as his own shakti. That is the idea there. It is all adhyasa. In Siddhanta, it is all adhyasa. But to argue with the Purvapakshi, we are saying that if buddhi by itself is going to take the shakti, actually, how does the jiva also claim the shakti of the indriyas? Through the buddhi, it has been said, vijnanena. Buddhya. Buddhya shakti grahanam asya jivasya. Or prananam indriyanam shakti grahaha. Vijnanena buddhina buddhya bhavati asya jivasya. For this jiva, the taking up of the power, owning up of the indriya's power, the sense organ, power of the sense organs is through the buddhi. It through this buddhi which connects, antakkarana which connects this jiva to the indriyas. He has no direct access to the indriyas without the buddhi being the gateway. Antakkarana being the gateway, which you have seen earlier. Without that, there will be what? Nitya upalabdhi or nitya anupalabdhi, we have seen in the earlier patha. So this gateway is the buddhi. Now if the buddhi itself will becomes the karta, then kartri, then buddhi will take the shakti of the indriyas. Therefore the karana shakti has to undergo change, because this vijnana buddhi, which is a gateway as a karana, that karana has taken up the kartru shakti. Because does something, adaya you say lyabanta, then it is like, it is a replacement for twa. You cannot complete the sentence there. Having taken what? Something, does something. So whatever is the kriyapada following in the Shruti, does something, buddhi does something, therefore buddhi has taken up the shakti and has become the kartri. So how can there be karana shakti also? That which has a karana shakti, that will undergo change and will be replaced by kartri shakti. This will be the fault there if you take. This will be the dosha. It is not the right interpretation, says the सिद्धांत इति पूर्व पक्षी बुद्धे कर्तृत्वे सति कर्णशक्ति विपर्ययात कर्णशक्ति वुड अंडरगो चेंज एंड ड्यू टू दैट कर्णशक्तिर हीयेत इति यावत कर्णशक्ति विल गो अवे देन इट कैन नॉट एक्ट लाइक अ मीन्स टू समथिंग इट विल नॉट बी अ मीन्स टू नॉलेज एट ऑल बिकॉज बुद्धि हैज स्टार्टेड डूइंग समथिंग इट हैज बिकम कर्तृ एंड इट हैज स्टॉप बीइंग कर्ण यू कैन नॉट यूज द बुद्धि एनी मोर सो So basically, indirectly, if you read sarcasm into it, you can say that you who is arguing, if buddhi is the karta, meaning buddhi is the kartri, kartrupada. Difficult to say in English because Sanskrita gender will come into play. So let's just say I'll use an English word for here for this case. So if buddhi is the agent of action, what happens there? So, as a sarcasm, you can see that for the Purvapakshi, if the buddhi has become the agent of action, then Purvapakshi cannot use the intellect anymore. So, this is the, you can read a little bit of sarcasm there, just for, what is called as Vidvat Manoranjana. Anyway, that's an aside. But Karna Shakti hi eta, Karna Shakti would go away. Is it acceptable to you? At least that without sarcasm also you should say, is it acceptable? It is not acceptable. Jnana sadhana vidya anyatha anupapatyapi atmana kartrutvam svikaryam ityah. So atmana kartrutvam, jivatmana kartrutvam svikaryam eva. It has to be accepted by you as well, says the Siddhanti to the Purvapakshi. Why should you accept? ज्ञान साधन विधि अन्यथा अनुपपत्यापि बाय अन्यथा अनुपपत्ति अन्यथा अनुपपत्ति शुड बी एक्सेप्टेबल एज अ प्रमाण मीनिंग अन्यथा अनुपपत्ति लीड्स टू अर्थापत्ति प्रमाण फॉर द वेदांतिन बट तार्किकास एंड सम अदर मेनी अदर्स एक्सेप्ट फॉर वन टाइप ऑफ अ कपल ऑफ टाइप ऑफ दार्शनिकास अर्थापत्ति इज नॉट अ सेपरेट प्रमाण इट इज अनुमान अंतर्गत विद इन अनुमान विच इज एक्सेप्टेबल टू ऑलमोस्ट ऑल दार्शनिकास एक्सेप्ट फॉर चार्वाकास बट अनुमान विच इज अ प्रमाण यूजिंग मल्टीपल स्टेप्स ऑफ अनुमान वन कैन से अनुपपत्ति विच यू हैव सीन यू नो दिवा अभुंजानस्य देवदत्तस्य रात्रिभोजनम अनुपपत्या ज्ञायते हाउ डू यू नो दैट देवदत्त ईट्स एट नाइट बिकॉज ही रिमेन्स टू बी फैट व्हाइल फॉलोइंग उपवास इन द डे थ्रू आउट द डे ही डज नॉट ईट एंड स्टिल अक्रॉस सेवरल मंथ्स ही कंटिन्यूज टू रिमेन फैट इवन गेन्स वेट हाउ कैन दैट बी is not possible without food and you have not seen him having food meaning he has food when you have not seen that is the anyatha anupapatti otherwise not possible he is being fat I mean these days you have all these you cannot call use the word blind you say visually impaired in I am old school so just by changing So you can insult a person and have disrespect using the visually impaired word also or calling somebody handicapped also these are all old school words personally I feel that there is no reason to reinvent words you can use a different tone and a person who has bad samskaras will anyway insult with the best of the language somebody who is skilled in using who has great language skills will insult the other in such a manner that other does not know that there is an insult like we saw some sarcasm may be hidden so whatever words you use if you use them appropriately there is no harm so you have to keep in touch with the new pronouns now pronouns are being recreated with new pronouns you should use plural for a singular also with the new gender I am old school, so I will continue to use these unless something triggers. For example, if you say somebody is here, In example of what? Anyatha Anupapatti, you say Devata is fat, Pina. So if the memory triggers and works there, I can say stout. There is no body shaming here. These days they'll say, oh, you call someone fat, how dare you? Body shaming. Hey, people call me thin. Is that body shaming? It's a fact. These are just words. Do not have these useless ideas that you have. These people have. They should not have these ideas and think that, oh, I am body shaming. So anyway, so that's an aside. I'm just saying that I use these words, but then YouTube has its own way to look at it. I wouldn't be surprised if it is flagged. So, in some era that comes up. So anyway, that's the pun intended. But look at this. Devadatta is Peena, is fat, although he does not eat during the day. And since there is a Nitya Sambandha, there is a Vyapti between eating food and gaining weight or retaining that weight. If you do not eat, then the body eats up the fat. If one has fat, well and good, the fat will go away by Upavasa, not eating. But this fellow is retaining the weight, even gaining. Why? It has to be because he eats at night. This is possible by multiple steps of Anumana also. Therefore, the Tarkikas say that Arthapatti is not a separate Pramana. But Arthapatti is a separate Pramana because it is not multiple step inference at all. You already have the Vyapti in your mind. And you already know this. You are not using the Vyapti here. You just already have the knowledge that food leads to gaining weight for sustenance of life also. Now, if you are looking at it in that manner, then Anyatha Anupapatti is a single step there as to he looks at Devadatta, who remains so across multiple months and is not eating. Suddenly, without thinking, without making the Vyapti connection at all, without using Anumana at all, one says that, oh, he must be, suddenly concludes, he must be eating at night. Anyway, that's Anyatha Anupapatti, which we already know. Now, this Jnana Sadhana Vidhi, is it there or not? In the Shruti, there is a Vidhi. Atma Vare Drashtavyaha Shrotavyo Mantavyo Nididhyasitavyaha. So, Atma Vare Drashtavyaha. Atma Darshana should be done. How? Shravanena, Mananena, Nididhyasena. That is the Artha as Sadhana. How? Shrotavyaha, Mantavyaha, Nididhyasitavya. So, Shrotavya means Shravana. Shravana is the means. Shravanena ityartha. Similarly, Mantavya means through Manana and Nididhyasitavya means through Nididhyasana. So, Jnana Sadhana is Shravana Manana Nididhyasana. And with the Tavya Pratyaya, it is a Vidhi. Shrotavyaha. Shravanam Kartavyena Kuryat. One should do Shravana as a Kartavya. As a Vidhi, it has been said that you have to do it. Who has to do it? One who wants the Phala, obviously. If I want Moksha, that Moksha is possible only by Jnana. That Jnana is revealed in the Shruti. Therefore, I have to do Shravana, I have to do. There is no saying that optional. There is nothing optional there. It is a Vidhi. Shrotavyaha, Vidhi. Mantavyaha, Vidhi. Nididhyasitavya, Vidhi. For one who wants Moksha, Jnana is a Vidhi, and through Jnana, one has to, for Jnana, one has to do Shravana, Manana, Nididhyasana. Now, this Vidhi is applicable to whom? It cannot be for the Buddhi. How can Buddhi do Shravana? How can Buddhi do Manana? How can Buddhi do Nididhyasana? Now, Nididhyasana can also be understood as Samadhi. Samadhi is, and Samadhi can be taken as a Chittavritti Nirodha Rupa Samadhi. So that Chittavritti Nirodha Samadhi, where Chitta Chittavritti will mean buddhivritti, because chitta is antakkarana. Antakkarana plays the role of buddhi also. So if antakkarana itself is resolved, meaning the antakkarana vrittis are resolved, how will buddhi survive? So buddhi not surviving, can buddhi have samadhi? Can buddhi have nididhyasana? It is not possible. This is the anyatha anupapatti. Since the vidhi has been given by the shastra as jnana sadhana, meaning shravana vidhi, manana vidhi, and specifically here nididhyasana vidhi. Nididhyasana vidhi has been given by shastra, and if buddhi is kartri, then buddhi resolving the samadhi will not be possible, nididhyasana will not be possible for buddhi. Therefore, it has to be for atma, not for buddhi. Anyatha anupapatya. That is the meaning of anyatha anupapatti. And why I have taken samadhi? Because that is the sutra. Atmana kartrutvam svikaryam. Therefore, atma being the karta has to be accepted by even the purva pakshi. Samadhya bhavatya. Samadhya bhavatya. So, samadhya bhavatya. Samadehe abhavat shashti tatpurusha. Cha. And due to absence of samadhi, due to impossibility of samadhi. Why? Because if buddhi is the kartri, then samadhi will not be possible. And samadhi has been told as a means. Therefore, samadhi has to be possible. Shruti will not give you some useless means. They are purposeful means. And because Shruti has given the vidhi of nididhyasana, samadhi, and samadhi won't be possible if buddhi is the kartri, because buddhi has to stay and avoid the, I mean, buddhi practicing, buddhi being the kartri of samadhi, buddhi itself cannot resolve there, cannot have nirodha. So that nirodha rupa samadhi won't be possible. Buddhi itself cannot do. But then hypothetically, if buddhi is trying to get samadhi, it has to resolve. Buddhi cannot resolve. Otherwise, there is no, if buddhi resolves, there is samadhi, but buddhi won't be there. If buddhi has to be there as a kartri, then samadhi cannot be there. You have a caste entity situation. So Siddhanti is saying, you pick. Is buddhi the kartri? Then no samadhi is possible. And if samadhi is not possible, let it be. We don't care for samadhi. If that is the argument, okay, you don't care for the samadhi, all right. But do you care for the shastra or not? Can shastra give purposeless, useless kind of means? No. It is anishta to you also as an astika, as astika. So being astika, you cannot say that I don't care for samadhi, because even if you don't care for samadhi, samadhi is given as a means. If it is given as a means by shastra, then shastra to remain purposeful, samadhi has to be purposeful, and samadhi should be the resultant for someone. If samadhi is resultant, then buddhi cannot survive. Buddhi cannot be the kartri. If buddhi is the kartri, there cannot be samadhi. So to keep shastra meaningful, which has given samadhi as a means, as a vidhi, therefore anyatha anupapatya, buddhi cannot be kartri, but atma is the karta, because this samadhi is for the atma. Why? Atma vare drashtavyah. And this darshana also will take place through the buddhi. Manana is possible through the buddhi. Shravana is possible through Indriya, Shrotrendriya, but through the gateway of the buddhi. Therefore, you can read all those meanings also, additionally. Atmanaha akartrutve, atma vare drashtavya ityado vihitasya brahma sakshatkara sadhanasya. Jnana sadhana is, jnana is brahma sakshatkara. Aparoksha jnana itself is sakshatkara. So, aparoksha jnana sadhana vidhi. Brahma Sakshatkara Sadhana. So, Drashtavya is a Vidhi. Darshanam Kartavyam. Kena Sadhanena, Shravanena, Madanena, Nididhyasanena. So, Nididhyasa, which leads to Brahma Sakshatkara. Really, Shravana leads, but dependent means is also Nididhyasana. So Brahma Sakshatkara Sadhanasya Samadehe Abhav Prasangat. Samadhi, which is the sadhana for Brahma Sakshatkara, that itself will not be possible. That is the prasanga. यू विल हैव अ केस ऑफ नो समाधि देयर फॉर नो मीन्स फॉर ब्रह्म साक्षात्कार एंड दैट विधि विल बिकम पर्पसलेस इन दी श्रुति देयर बाय आत्मन कर्तृत्व सिद्धि देयर फॉर आत्मा हैज टू बी द कर्ता वेयर बुद्धि बिकम्स द मीन्स टू समाधि बुद्धि रिजॉल्व्स बट द आत्मा गेट समाधि जीवात्मा जीव गेट समाधि इत्थम सर्वगतत्वाद बहिष्टम कर्तृत्व प्रतिष्ठापितम बहिष्टम इज आउटसाइड आउटसाइड फ्रॉम वॉट कंपेयर टू वॉट सर्वगत सर्वगतत्व सो कंपेयर टू सर्वगतत्व कर्तृत्व इज ऑफ आउटसाइड मीनिंग इट इज नॉट विद इन द टॉपिक इट इज ऑन द बाउंड्री सो टू से सेपरेट सो कर्तृत्व इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम सर्वगतत्व सर्वगतत्व सी सर्वगत सर्वगत आत्मा इज नॉट कर्ता सो हू इज द कर्ता कर्ता इज बहिष्टा फ्रॉम सर्वगत आत्मा मीनिंग वॉट औपाधिक औपाधिक आत्मा इज द कर्ता नॉट द सर्वगत आत्मा ब्रह्मरूप आत्मा इज नॉट द कर्ता बट जीव रूप आत्मा इज द कर्ता हू इज सेपरेट फ्रॉम द सर्वगत आत्मा ब्रह्मरूप आत्मा दैट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ बहिष्ट कर्ता एंड बहिष्टम कर्तृत्व प्रतिष्ठापित इट हैज बीन एस्टैब्लिश्ड मीनिंग औपाधिक कर्तृत्व इज देयर फॉर जीव हैज बीन एस्टैब्लिश्ड विच इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम द स्वरूप ऑफ द आत्मा विच इज रिवील्ड बाय सर्वगतत्व श्रुति अधुना तत् अध्यस्थम आत्मनि इति प्रतिपादयति दैट दिस कर्तृत्व इज औपाधिक हैज टू बी एस्टैब्लिश्ड इट हैज बीन एस्टैब्लिश्ड एज कर्तृत्व कर्तृत्व हैज बीन एस्टैब्लिश्ड एंड इट इज सेपरेट फ्रॉम द सर्वगत आत्मा नाउ इट इज औपाधिक और नॉट फॉर द सिद्धांति इट इज औपाधिक इट इज उपाधिकृत दि शरीरत्रय इज एन उपाधि वेर दे जीवा हैज इ तादात्म्य संबंध एंड द सर्वगत आत्मा एज दो बिकम्स देहगत बिकम्स लिमिटेड टू दि स्थूल सूक्ष्म शरीर वाइल बीइंग सर्वगत सो देयरफॉर एज दो बिकम्स लिमिटेड एंड दिस लिमिटेड इज अ संसारी जीवात्मा इज संसारी ब्रह्मात्मा सर्वगत आत्मा इज नॉट अ संसारी सो वॉट इज दिस जीव नाउ जीव स्वरूप इज सर्वगतत्व जीव हैज सर्वगत स्वरूप ब्रह्म इज द स्वरूप ऑफ जीव बट जीव हू इज अ संसारी इज अ संसारी बिकॉज ऑफ उपाधि संबंध देयरफॉर दिस कर्तृत्व इज ऑल्सो वॉट अध्यस्तम अधुना तत् तत् वॉट तत् कर्तृत्व अध्यस्तम कुत्र आत्मनि ब्रह्मात्मनि अध्यस्तम दिस ब्रह्मात्मा हू हैज टेकन द रोल ऑफ जीवात्मा अंटू दिस जीवात्मा हाउ हैज ही बिकम अ जीवात्मा संसारी जीव जीवात्मा मीन्स एक्चुअली जीवात्मा बाय स्वरूप इज ब्रह्मात्मा बट How has he this Atma, or rather, let me put in simpler words as to Atma word has been used here, which is Jivatma. So this Atma is none other than Brahma. Then how did Brahma become Atma? Anena Jivena Atmana Anupravishya. That Anupravishya Shruti says that this Brahma has become Jiva, has become Atma in the Sharira. So how has this Sarvagata become Sharira Gata? By the Sharira Sambandha, that Sharira Sambandha is Mithya, it is Adhyaropita. Therefore, all that which is the limiting factor or as a set of limiting factors, they are all superimposed on the jiva, adhyastha in jiva, atma. Therefore, adhyastham, atmani, adhyastham tat kartrutvam, iti pratipadayati. This is what the sutrakara establishes, reveals or argues and साधयति प्रतिपादयति ही एक्सप्लेन्स दैट एंड देन एस्टैब्लिशेस इति उपजीव्य उपजीवक भाव संगत्या इदमः मीनिंग दैट द कर्तृत्व इज द बेसिस कर्तृत्व हैज बीन एस्टैब्लिश्ड ऑफ द फॉर आत्मा एंड नाउ व्हाट सूत्रकार डज ही सेज दैट दिस कर्तृत्व इज नॉट रियल स्वरूप ऑफ आत्मा इट इज अध्यस्त इन आत्मा सो व्हाट द आर्ग्यूमेंट वॉज सो फार बुद्धि इज नॉट द कर्त्री बुद्धि इज नॉट द कर्त्री आत्मा इज द कर्ता So our approach is to refute the buddhi independently as kartri and show this independent atma is also not karta but to differentiate from the buddhi as karti, we have said that atma is karta, but which atma is karta? Or is atma karta by swarupa? No, by adhyastha sambandha, by adhyasa. Why? There is no jiva bhava unless buddhi itself becomes an upadhi for the atma. Otherwise, there is no jiva bhava, there is no individuality, there is no samsarityam. This samsarityam, kartrutvam itself leading to bhoktrutvam is samsarityam. That samsara itself has come up because one has taken up the buddhi dharmas to be one's own dharma. One has taken up the stula sharira, sukshma sharira dharmas as one's own dharmas because of the karana sharira association being there, avidya being there. This is the idea. So therefore, there is a dependency of this next adhikarana on the earlier adhikarana. Therefore, upajivya, upajiva bhava, jivaka bhava sangati. Taya idam ah. Takshadhikarana. So takshadhika, taksha is a carpenter. So carpenter is used an example, and thereby the next sutra yathacha takshobhayata. Yathacha takshobhayata. So yathacha taksha. उभयता सो यथा यथा लोके उभयता तथा तक्षा यथा लोके उभयता तक्षा दिस उभयता हैज टू बी अंडरस्टूड एज टू दिस तक्षा A carpenter, when he is working, when he is doing work of a carpenter, lot of work is there. And when he is working, just an example, you can take, need not be a carpenter, can be anyone. Take any laborer. So carpenter example has been used here, where there is lot of physical work. You have to take some example where there is lot of physical work, easier to understand for all. Mental work is not easy to understand for all. So they'll say, I mean, what does the manager do? What does this architect do? Does nothing. The real construction is done by the laborers. Architect, what has he done? So what architect has done, that is not visible to everyone. What the IAS officers do for the country, that is not seen. Whatever is buddhikarya, what is mentally you have to draw plans. But one who executes it, on the floor, not that they are not needed, both are needed, but it is easier to see shrama in physical work. The effort involved in the physical work can be seen by everyone. Mental work is not seen easily by everyone. Therefore, taksha example, the carpenter who is working a lot, any laborer who is working a lot has lot of physical work, therefore there is dukkha. Which we have seen earlier also, anishtam na kuryat, as a purva paksha. Now, why is the carpenter doing so much of work? The more work he does, the more is the money that he earns, more is the result. So, sukha will be more later, therefore he is putting lot of effort. Further what? When he is working throughout the day, let's say, you know, he is having a 14-16 hours work day. When he comes back to his, you know, freshens up and comes back to his room, has bhojana and then suddenly falls asleep, he does not have to struggle. That physical strain exhausts him and then he has sukha in nidra. Why in nidra? As soon as the work is over, he is happy. this load of work is happy. And it is true for anyone. Taksha is just an example here. Now, the question that Siddhanti asks the Purva Pakshi is, this carpenter who is having lot of work, is undergoing dukkha during work, is that a swarupa? So this person who is playing the role of the laborer, he is not the laborer when he goes back home. Meaning he is not doing carpentry work. He is called a carpenter all right, but is he doing carpentry work? When he is at home and with his wife and children, he is having dinner. He is not a carpenter then. So carpentry is a role that he is playing. Because he is doing this carpentry work, he is called as a carpenter. By Swarupa is not a carpenter. By Swarupa, he is not always stressed with lot of work. He is not loaded with work. He is not experiencing dukkha all the time. After the work is over, he is happy. He is happy, he is sukhi. So that is the example Ubhayata. The same taksha is dukhi while doing lot of work. Dukhi in the sense, physically strained out. And the same taksha, after the work is over, is free from this dukkha, he is sukhi also. So how can you have sukha and dukkha going together as swarupa? Cannot be. So sitting, doing nothing and easily having no stress or strain is the swarupa of this taksha. But when he is working, that time he superimposes the carpenter's dharma and thereby becomes loaded with stress, strain, and then becomes dukkhi. So dukkha is not a swarupa. Sukha meaning being free from work is a swarupa. As a person, as an individual, as a person, while not playing the role, while not in the office or while not in the workplace, factory or whatever, this person, as a person, if you look at him, in his swarupa, he is free from the stress. The stress is superimposed. Why do you take so much of workload? Can be asked to anyone. Manager comes back home and he says that I had to, you know, do so much today. So why do you do so much of work? Why do you take so much of load? You can delegate. So then a person who has become a manager, Anil, does not delegate well, or is unable to delegate for whatever reasons, prefers the earlier work or habituated to earlier work, does not delegate, and then so much of work is there. His manager in turn says, why are you taking so much of load? Delegate. You have so many people at your disposal now, assistants. Why don't you give away work to them? Why do you keep on doing everything? So by Swarupa, this person can be separated out or not. Similarly, this Atma by Swarupa is Brahma, Satchidananda Brahma. Through the example, landing on the exemplified. So the same Atma, when he takes the Upadhi of the Shariratraya, that time he is a Karta. So Kartrutva is not his Swarupa Dharma. Swarupa Dharma is Satchidananda. But Ubhayata, it is the same Atma. Same Atma appears to be the Karta Bhokta Atma, and same Atma is Satchidananda Atma. It depends on your perspective. Therefore, Shuddha Atma, Brahmatma, has Kartrutva Adhyasta in him unto himself, unto oneself. That is the Sutrartha. We will see the Vritti, which is a little longer than the other Vrittis, and a little complex also. So we'll spend some time here to see some different ideas. Actually, I forgot, I had marked some ideas in the earlier part, but it's all right. We have moved on. I don't want to go back and explain. I wanted to do it today at the opening of the Patha. I forgot to put a note there as to I have to revisit them. But I had marked some things to mention, but it's okay. We've not something that we have missed a lot, but here I hope to remember to cover that, and we'll see that in next Patha. Amnayantiksam Siddham Adhi Madhyantavarjitam Anandaghanam Apurnam Atma Jyoti Rupasmahe Namaste Dhanyavada.
Namaste. Thank you.